Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We don't have a huge amount of updates today, but we'll start with standard SpaceX information. Then we have a variety of updates and stuff to take a look at in Boca Chica with Starship development. Let's head straight in and get up to date. First up, here's a cool video posted by SpaceX to commemorate their 100th successful mission. A new article posted by NASA has an update on the Crew 1 mission with them targeting no earlier than 7:49pm EST or 11:49pm UTC on Saturday, November 14th. I also want to add some other dates which we can expect more launches in November. We have November 4th for the launch of GPS-3 Space Vehicle 4. Then there is November 10th for the launch of Sentinel 6. Plus there is the November 15th targeted launch date for Crew 1. There's a new article about how much Starlink is going to cost initially. For the service itself, customers will pay $99 per month and they will also have to pay $499 for the Starlink kit. This public beta will also be called the Better Than Nothing Beta. A company called Leo Labs has partnered with SpaceX to support tracking of Starlink satellites during their initial on-orbit phase. Taking a look over in Boca Chica, we recently saw a new tent erected at the orbital launch pad. In a recent drive-by, Mary caught some great footage of what looks to be converted shipping containers that have been placed next to the tent. Also caught was some footage of SpaceXers working inside this new tent as they prepare it for its intended use. After having recently lifted and supported SN8's missing fairing, the crane known as Tankzilla was spotted moving elsewhere in the launch area. We recently saw them building what looked to be a new wall at the restaurant area. Here we can see that there's a new building coming along nicely. Over at the old Gaswell lot, some new structure pieces were spotted being moved around. There's another new infrastructure arrival to the construction yard with this giant gantry crane to be installed in a new high bay. Here's a view of the high bay which should get some super heavy sections to be stacked in the not too distant future. Nick Cummings from SpaceX recently showed some nice aerial shots on a Zoom call. Reporter Masia Smith tweeted with the caption "Aerial view of Boca Chica," and one of SN8 on the pad getting ready to fly to 15 kilometers with 3 Raptor engines. SN9 and 10 in production. 50 Raptors built now, production rate will increase. First orbital flight next year, booster in construction now. I want to throw in this article about Gwynne Shotwell saying Starship could help with cleaning up space debris as well as all the other stuff it can do. The new nose cone we recently saw under construction potentially for SN9 has been moved outside. Also, inside the fabrication tent you can see another new nose being built, SN10 maybe? This nose cone that was moved outside was also prepared and lifted off of the construction mount it was on. Something else spotted being moved out of a tent was a new four-ring stack. Could this be another super heavy barrel section? Taking a look in the yard where this stack was moved to, we can see the growing collection of Starship and super heavy pieces. Nearby these new rings is a smaller stack which has some holes in it. I wonder what they are doing here. In the production area there was also a new arrival with this fin that was seen on a trailer covered up. Since SN9 is awaiting two of these, it's likely that this is for that Starship. Taking a look at other vehicles, we have the stunning SN8, which is the first full-size Starship since Mark 1. For many days the crane was holding up the nose as engineers continued to work on preparing it for its upcoming tests and flights. You saw earlier that the crane has since been detached from SN8, so this machine is now standing tall on its own. They've also been working beneath the vehicle as they work on the Raptors, with one recently removed and another Raptor installed. With SN8, we also have some road closures cancelled, with today and tomorrow no longer expected. However, the backup date of Friday is also still scheduled, so a little more of a wait, but hopefully not too long. Also for this video, we have the SN11 common dome we recently saw sleeved. It's now hooked up to a crane and waiting to be flipped into the correct orientation. Finally for the video, we also have an interesting piece of SN12 spotted in the windbreaker with this nose cone barrel section. Of course, I have to thank the amazing Mary, or Boca Chica girl, for her time and dedication to filming the progress every day. Plus, thanks to the amazing NASA spaceflight team also working behind the scenes to bring us incredible space coverage. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.